A very good evening to one and all present here, and welcome back to day two, the concluding day of the Ceylonian International Film Festival 2020. We begin our session today with an address by our keynote speaker, Mr. Nikhil Balal. Mr. Nikhil is an enthusiastic media professional and the managing editor of Thane's oldest and successful Marathi daily, Thane Vaibhav. He has pioneered the first exclusive city magazine called the KYT, Know Your Town. Under this initiative, he has interviewed more than 200 eminent personalities of Maharashtra. Singhania School cordially welcomes you, sir, to this platform to share your perspective of the evolution of Marathi cinema.
Hello, good evening all. Thank you so much for inviting me. It is a pleasure to be a part of a Ceylonian activity. It is always very special. 70 mm and 100 years of film industry and 3 minutes. So you can just imagine it's a Herculean task in front of me to elaborate the evolution of Marathi film industry in only 3 minutes. But to make it simple, what I've done is I have divided this entire 100 years into three eras. So basically 1960 to 1980, 1980 to 2000, and 2000 till date, that is 2020. So you'll understand the Marathi film industry, how it has evolved in these three eras. So in the first era, that is 1960 to 1980, if we talk about the Marathi film industry, like Maharashtra was just formed. Like we all know that Maharashtra came into existence in the year 1960. And it was exactly in this era that the first national award was given to a Marathi film exactly in this era, and which was Shyamchi Aayi. I think all of you must have seen Shyamchi Aayi. It's a wonderful film by Mr. Prahlad Atre. And that actually gave an impetus to the Marathi film industry. It gave a momentum and it motivated all the filmmakers to develop films more and more for Marathi film industry. So as we know that Maharashtra came into existence, so at that time, all the filmmakers mainly concentrated on the pride of Maharashtra, which was the various forms of folks. And the most popular form of folk during that time was Tamasha. And many films we saw that time were mainly on this form, that was Tamasha. And that is how the Marathi films became popular, especially in the rural part of Maharashtra. And we had some fabulous filmmakers during this era, like we had V. Shantaram, we had Master Vinayak, then we had Anant Mane, who directed some films on Tamasha. Then exactly in this era, we had one of the finest comedians ever the Marathi film industry has had, which is Dada Kondke. We all know him, Dada Kondke. He was very famous for his satirical dialogues, and he was famous for his pun-ridden movies. And he was the pull factor during this era. People actually used to come to see him, watch him, and he kept people captivated. He kept people engaged during this era. Now, as the years passed, in 1980, the Marathi cinema content evolved. It mainly focused more on a family drama or on more on political drama. And again, the essence, the humor was still there. Like the movies were still very humorous, hilarious. And we witnessed a excellent, impeccable chemistry of Ashok Saraf and Lakshmikant Berde. Like people used to go and visit the theater to see their chemistry. Their comic timing was really fabulous. We had a lot of double meaning dialogues during that time. Slapstick comedy was there. Then we had Mr. Sachin Pilgaonkar and Mahesh Kothari, who directed some wonderful films, especially in this era. But then as our audience was maturing, this content gradually became very monotonous. And that was when the Marathi film industry started declining, especially in the late 90s, 95, because people were tired of watching the same content again and again. So in the year 2000, 2004, to be very precise, so that is in the third era, which we are in right now, the movie came Shwas, which was a path-breaking movie in the Marathi film industry. I think many of you must have seen or at least heard about it. It was a movie like an evergreen movie, and people loved it, and it again bagged a national award. And actually, after that movie, again, people started watching Marathi films, they started following Marathi films, because people started getting the content, what they were actually expecting from the Marathi films. So then we had Shwas, then we had some biopics also, like Harishchandrachi Factory, which was based on the life of the father of Indian cinema, that is Dadasaheb Phalke, his struggle in making the film. Then again, that back then national award. Then we had Kashinath Ghanekar, one of the renowned filmmakers we ever had. So again, a biopic on that, and a recent biopic also we witnessed was on Thackeray. So there was a very good content which started coming in. Exactly in this era, we had some different content also and different technology and innovations which were also used by different filmmakers. Like Mahesh Kothari, a renowned film director, he started the digital Dolby sound. He first used, especially in this era, in his film Chimney Pakhre. Then we again had some special effects in Zapat Leela 2. Then we had some good digital sound, Dolby sound in Pachad Leela. So the Marathi film was started upgrading itself. It was matching the new technology and the innovations which were seen all across the world. And that is how the Marathi viewers, Marathi audience were hooked, were engaged again back to the Marathi films. Then we saw some fabulous movies like Natrang. I think Natrang, even all of you must have seen. It had all those SOPs. Now, currently, this SOP word has been used a lot, especially because of Corona. So it had all the SOP of making it a blockbuster movie. It had a wonderful music. It had wonderful dialogues, a good screenplay, good cinematography, which was all seen in Natrang. Exactly the same happened with Duniyadari. Again, like the young audience who are more interested to watch romantic movies, college, teenage movies. So again, that need was quite met in Duniyadari, which was again crafted by Sanjay Jadhav. Then we had Nagaraj Manjule, as we are all aware of, Sairat. And Sairat was one of the movies like which created history in Marathi films. Like 100 crore of box office collection. Never ever anyone thought that a Marathi film will make 100 crores because a Marathi market is only restricted to Maharashtra. But then now the 100 crore achievement was been secured by this particular movie. And again, this movie had a wonderful music, wonderful cinematography, and it was a very different concept altogether. And usually we have seen that the Bollywoods remake South movies. But for a change, we could see that the Bollywood was remaking Sairat. So this is how the Marathi cinema has evolved. Dharma Production, eventually they remade this film, Sairat, and we saw it in Bollywood as well. So the Marathi cinema has evolved a lot. They have really changed their content. They have really changed the packaging and the look and feel. And now even they are now available on OTT platforms like Netflix, Voot, and Sony Live, and et cetera, et cetera. So I feel that Marathi cinema right now is in very safe hands, and they are matching the new standards. They are adapting to the new taste and preferences of the audiences. And the content is also changing, and which is quite captivating and engaging at the same time. Thank you so much for inviting me. It was a pleasure talking here. Way back to you, Raj Nandini.
Thank you, Nikhil sir, for sharing the journey of Marathi cinema. Now, we move on to the first segment of the day, which is dedicated to Andrzej Witold Wajda. He was a Polish film director as well as a theater director. He was a recipient of the Honorary Oscar, the Palme d'Or, the Honorary Golden Lion Awards, as well as the Honorary Golden Bear Awards. He was a prominent member of the Polish Film School, a group of highly talented individuals whose works came into recognition to their countries post the World War II reality. We wish to thank our Polish friends for this upcoming film on Andrzej Wajda. And now with this follows the first set of Indian and Polish movies.
Thank you. is Harish. He is a receptionist at the Apollo Hospital and works relentlessly to meet the needs of his family.
Papa, पूरे 90% आए हैं।
क्या बात है बेटा, बहुत बढ़िया मार्क्स लाए हैं आपने।
चलो मुझे बताओ, इतने अच्छे नंबर तो आ गए, लेकिन इसके आगे क्या करना चाह रहा था ना?
मुझे जेई की एग्जाम देनी है और आईआईटी से इंजीनियर बनना।
कर। अच्छा चलो हम देखते हैं कुछ।
Hello Harish, how are you?
Oh Mahesh, I am great yaar. Do you know anyone who is taking JEE classes for engineering? Because these coaching classes na are really going out of budget. They're too expensive. Please let me know if anyone is there.
Yes, I surely look for him.
Hello, is this Vijay sir speaking?
Yes.
Harish, father of Prav.
Yes, Mahesh told me that you'll call.
Yes, sir. I actually wanted to inquire regarding the JEE classes which you take. I also wanted to enroll my child in. Can you please tell me about the fees, sir?
See, I know your situation. Mahesh told me about it. It's completely fine if you don't pay me right now.
Thank you so much, sir.
Under the supervision of Mr. Mehta, the tutor, Prab excelled not only in his studies but also pursued engineering further. A few months later.
Oh my god, Mom! Hello, Vijay, yaar. Mama has fallen down in an unconscious state and she's not waking up. I've tried calling the doctor but he's not picking up the phone. Please do something.
Acha, listen, you calm down. I'll do something. Arre, don't panic, I'll do something. Calm down.
Ma!
Harish, suno na.
Yes sir, what happened? Why are you going
to sab chodo? My mom fell down, she's unconscious. So, push me nahi, at least kuch karo na.
Okay sir. Okay sir, I'll just call the ambulance right now. You just don't worry and go back home right away.
Thank you so much.
The world is round. They say what goes around comes around. Always be grateful and kind. No one is less than another. Always keep that in mind.
Hi, my name is Karina. I'm 15 years old. I like dancing and drawing. In the movie, I played a bad character.
Hi, I'm Veronica. I'm 15 years old. I live in Krakow and I'm attending a high school here. I'm interested in sports, traveling and art. I hope you will like our video.
Hey, my name is Jarek. I'm 50 years old. I like coding and I play bad character in movie.
Hi guys, I'm Paula and I'm from Poland. I really like drawing.
In one city tyranny were two group of people who didn't like each other very much.
Hey Veronica, what's up?
Hi Paula, not well. I felt very humiliated by Karina and Jarek.
What happened?
When I was returning home, I missed the bus and the car splashed me. And what's the worst, Karina and Jarek saw this accident and they all laughed at me.
Oh no.
Oh my god, Jaro, I still laugh at Veronica and with her bad luck.
It's all very funny.
I have an idea what to do to laugh at them yet.
Speak.
Let's pretend we had an argument. Then you tell Paula about this and ask, can you talk to them?
Okay, let's do this.
Hello, Veronica. Jarek wrote to me and asked if he could join to us.
Hi, I'm not sure. Yesterday he was laughing at me.
I think we can trust him.
Okay, add him to the conversation.
Hey.
Hi.
Hi.
Arinka is horrible. I never would be friends her again.
We like her too.
How about a little to get to know each other? Maybe I'll start. I like play computer games. And what is your hobbies?
We like drawing.
Wow, I'd like see your arts. What are you afraid of? For me, ghosts are terrible.
I don't know. I'm not afraid of anything.
I am very afraid of spiders.
Karina and Jarek lived in the town. They liked to laugh and joke with others. This time they decided to laugh at Veronica and Paula. The following week they prepared a trap and scared Paula. She was in total shock. Jarek and Karinka were laughing at Paula. The moral is that you shouldn't trust your enemy.
He's texting me again.
Let's not panic. I'm going to handle this.
This guy again. Just ignore him, Ahana. Just ignore him. Let's just be smart with this.
I'm gonna win. I'm gonna win. I will not lose.
Thank you.
Once upon a time, there lived three friends in Krakow. One of them was very wise, another was intelligent and recurrent, but the third friend always believed in fate. One day, Julia heard a teacher who talked about an announced test tomorrow.
Hi Oliver and Leon, I heard about the announced test tomorrow. It will be very hard. I advise you not to go to school tomorrow.
No way, I'm ready to skip school.
Yes, me too. Whatever happens is my fate.
Julia didn't come to school today. Leon and Oliver wrote a test. Oliver decided to cheating and got a good mark. Then Leon wanted to write the test himself without any preparing and got a bad mark. A point we shouldn't believe in fate.
Our last segment for this festival is dedicated to Satyajit Ray, who was an Indian film director, writer, illustrator, and music composer. He was one of the greatest filmmakers of his times and is celebrated for works such as The Oppo Trilogy, The Music Room, The Big City, and Charulata. Satyajit Ray became the first Indian to receive an Honorary Academy Award at the Oscars in 1992 for his lifetime achievement. Most importantly, Ray is known for bringing in a revolution in Indian cinema through parallel cinema era with some movies that address ground realities prevailing in India post-independence. We now would like to bring forth the essence of Indian parallel cinema through a short film. This will be followed by the last set of Indian and Polish films.
Cinema. It has always been an intricate part of Indian upbringing. Whether it comes to the crowd going gaga over the action sequences in Sholay or allured by the charm of film like DDLJ and other SRK classics. But there was a certain segment in India which was considered the golden era of Indian cinema. It was called the New Wave or Parallel Cinema. This cinematic movement was inspired by Italian neorealism, which were Italian and French masterpieces on the wrangles faced by citizens after World War II. The Bicycle Thief is considered one of those classics. The movement started in 1950s in the state of West Bengal. It was taken forward by internationally acclaimed filmmakers like Satyajit Ray, Mrinal Sen, Hrithik Ghatak and Bimal Roy. These films are less concerned with offering spectacle and glamour and tended towards a social realistic approach to real-life scenarios. They focused on social and political issues such as the position of women in the society, caste, and poverty. These films are usually produced in a low budget and very less dependent on well-known actors. Maybe these films weren't box office recipients, but they were appreciated worldwide. This was reflected with Satyajit Ray winning the Golden Lion at the Venice Film Festival for Aparajito, the Golden Bear and Silver Bear are the same at the Berlin Film Festival. After some years though, parallel cinema had a huge decline. The rising cost of film production was one of them. Another major reason for the turmoil of parallel cinema was a National Film Development Corporation that did not take film distribution seriously. And the saddest part was, people wanted more entertainment. No one wanted to see the struggles of real life and hence lost its audience. Later in the 90s and early 2000s, India was introduced to new noir films like Satya, Company and Black Friday, which are modern day versions of realistic films. Today, the new age films are a combination of entertainment and social issues. Films like Stree, Bala and Thappad cover topics which are highly relatable to Indians. In a finishing note, parallel cinema had its own short run in the industry. But even today, it is appreciated worldwide for its fine cinematic work.
Sanjana, a single mother along with a daughter, is going in search of her elder brother Mohan. Sanjana just separated from her husband who took all her money and left her homeless.
Hey brother, I know you don't want to see me, but I really need your help.
Sanjana, what are you doing here? What do you want now?
I'm sorry Sanjana, I just can't help you. Let me show you out.
Sanjana and Mohan were embroiled in a battle for inheritance. Mohan was eyeing Sanjana's share as well, which was to her disadvantage.
Bhaiya, please, just consider this once again. I really need a place to stay.
No means no, right? Just find yourself another place to stay.
Excuse me, ma'am. I couldn't help overhearing. But if you really need a place to stay, I am looking for a tenant for my apartment near Hill Road.
Yes, sir. I really need a place to reside and I'll be forever grateful if you rent me your place.
Great then. I am ready to show you the apartment right now.
Sir, this apartment is really great. I think I should go ahead with this place. Kindly let me know the amount.
It's 25
people. 1 year later, the tables had turned and Sanjana was doing really well. In contrast, Mohan went bankrupt due to some illegal financial activities.
Hey, I heard about your brother. How is he holding up?
Well, I don't think that this is a good time to talk about it.
Look, Sanjana, he really needs your help. His penthouse is going to be confiscated. And if only you could help him by paying off the mortgage, he would have a house.
Well, you make a good point. I'll think about it.
Thank you, Sanjana. Thank you very much. I am eternally indebted to you. But what made you change your mind? I never expected that you would help me, especially after everything that I did to you.
Mohan, you should know that. I wasn't intending to help you earlier. If you really want to be thankful to anyone, then you should be thankful to Mr. Kabir. He's the one who made me realize that no matter how much I deny it, you are my only family. Besides, it also makes me the bigger person.
Yeah, you're right. And you know what? Families are like the branches on a tree. We grow in different directions, yet our roots remain as one.
Oh really? You just made that up, didn't you?
Nah, I just read it somewhere.
Hi, I had loads of fun while scripting and directing the film.
Writing a story and bringing it to life was a ton of fun.
Editing the film let my creativity flow and I challenged myself to lens I hadn't before.
I enjoyed the process and loved collaborating with my friends.
It was a great and an amazing experience and I'm glad to be a part of it.
I'm so glad to have been given the opportunity to work in the sound department of the film. Thank you very much.
Hi, how are you?
Happy birthday! I am so excited!
Thank you so much. I can't wait to meet you in the evening.
I know, right?
Yes. Chal na, I got to go. I'll talk to you later. Bye.
Bye.
Outbreak. Stay home, stay safe, wear a mask.
Perdón.
Hi, what's up?
Hey, happy birthday!
Thank you so much. Last year was so fun. I wish we could meet again, but I guess we'll just have to have a virtual birthday party.
I know, right? I will be there, definitely.
Yes. Bye.
Bye.
Happy birthday, Nitya.
Happy birthday, Nitya.
Happy birthday, Nitya. Happy birthday. Happy birthday. Let's sing a song for her, guys. Happy birthday to you. Happy birthday, dear Nitya. Happy birthday to you.
Let's toast to this, guys. What's it? Thank you for the virtual party. Yay, cheers.
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 But I feel better when I'm dancing, yeah, yeah. Better when I'm dancing, yeah, yeah.
Yeah, yeah.
We can dance together. Makes you feel better when you're dancing, yeah, yeah.
Wait, I will help you. Don't worry about these girls. They are always so mean.
Thank you for your helpfulness of you. I remember to avoid them. Anyway, my name is Marta.
No problem. I'm Florian.
Would you like to sit with me?
Sure, why not?
No.
Okay, sit down, please.
These are the basics of physics. How can she not know that? Crazy.
Not your business. I can see. You better get
back away from here because the teacher will come soon.
Whatever.
Girl, stop. What is this behavior? Where are you destroying the school?
It's not us.
It's me. I'm sorry. I couldn't expect that for you, Marta.
It won't happen again. I promise.
Why did you take our guilt upon you?
One admonition won't make difference to me. And you might be having serious problem. But don't do that anymore.
It was very nice of you, but...
We shouldn't be rude to you. We promise we won't be like that anymore.
I heard about what you did, but tell me honestly why, after all, they tested you.
Despite how they behaved towards me, I forgive them. They did it wrong, but it is worth helping. You never know when you will need help. I don't know. Maybe it will make them change and act differently. We shouldn't make enemies, but friends.
After having seen all of these amazing films, we now move on to our panel discussion, where I will be joined by Tanya and Aisha. The students have been experimenting with various techniques throughout the making of these films. To guide and enlighten us about the nuances of this craft, we will now be having a short panel discussion with three of our special invitee guests. Our first guest is Mr. Arun Gupta. Mr. Gupta is an alumnus of the very prestigious Film and Television Institute of India in Pune. After passing out from FTII in 1998, he has worked as a cinematographer and a producer and has more than 300 projects, which include several music videos, commercials, corporate films, the Art of Living series, and etc. Sir has worked as a DOP for shows like Bollywood Business, Starry Nights Gen Y, etc. On a special note, sir has been our mentor for this filmmaking project. Welcome to you, sir.
Hello. Good evening.
Good evening, sir. Our second guest for today is Mr. Shubrato Ghosh. Right from his childhood days, Mr. Ghosh has been passionate about photography and cinema. After studying art at the Vishwabharati Shantiniketan, sir joined the Film and Television Institute of India, where he graduated in cinema. He is the recipient of the highly prestigious Ambassadorial Fulbright Scholarship from the USA. Sir has been working in the video and film industry of Mumbai and Kolkata for the last 36 years in the field of editing, art, direction, photography, music, etc., which cover the creative and aesthetic aspect of cinema. Sir has also worked as a film editor in Kolkata Doordarshan. We welcome you, sir.
Our third guest on the panel today is Mr. Rohit Pradhan. Mr. Rohit Pradhan is associated with some of the most successful films in the Marathi film industry. After post-graduating in audio production from the University of Westminster, Mr. Pradhan has worked relentlessly to establish himself as one of the most successful and one of the most talented sound designers in recent times. This has also earned him his first Marathi Filmfare Award for his work in director Abhijit Panse's Regen. And on a special note, it's a pleasure to introduce him on this platform as an ex-Cylonian. Welcome, sir. I would also like to invite our friends from our partner school, Yulia, Merek, Martina, and Kasia. My first question is to you, Arun, sir. So I would like to ask you that when we watch our short films and the films in the theater, there seems to be a difference in the both. So can you please explain to us what makes these two different? Also, what should we keep in our minds to make our short films look like feature-length movies?
So the question that why they look different, maybe for various reasons. Cameras that are used, lenses that are used, lighting, and the way the shot is taken. So how you can improve is by you by using different lenses, cameras, different magnifications, and definitely trying to see how lighting affects your shot. I think these are basic things that change the appearance of film when we talk of just in terms of visuals. I hope that answers your question.
So thank you so much.
Shubhrata sir, what in your opinion is the perfect shot in terms of direction?
As we know, the shot is the basic unit of our film, and all that we want to say must be included in that shot. So it is actually based on perception of the individual who's taking that shot and his or her aptitude. Now, we can say actually that there cannot be a perfect shot, because a shot which might be perfect for me might be different for you. You might take it in a different way and it might be even better, or it might be less better than what I did. So I don't think there can be a perfect shot in that sense. But what needs to be there is that it must incorporate all that you are trying to say within that shot. That is conducted by your angle, the lens you use, the type of light you use, your composition. Whether it's a static shot, whether it's a moving shot, whether it's a long shot, close up. So these things determine whether your shot is working out with the context that you are shooting that shot for. But say, for instance, we've heard about the Russian angle, which is a very diagonal or low angle or top angle, not a straightforward shot. The Russians use it wonderfully. Eisenstein has used it magnificently. But in the same context, Charlie Chaplin, one of the greatest filmmakers, he says that in his autobiography, which also has a name which is quite funny, it is almost like an autobiography. He says that, I don't believe in shots which are like the viewpoint of a piece of coal from a fire, so looking right up to you. So it depends on what you want to say within that shot. Is that, I think been able to explain a little bit. There are lots of things go into it, but in short, that is one of the...
Rohit, sir, I would like you ask about soundtrack of films. Usually use original pop or folk music.
Hi everyone, it's been an interesting evening with all the films which students have made. So getting to Marek's question, I am in the opinion of using original music. It could be just a guitar player playing to your visuals, or it could be just a piano player. When you use pop music or any commercially released music, it boils down to copyright issues. So depending on your subject, you could experiment with different music tracks which are fitting well with the scene, which are carrying the emotions of the scene perfectly, and which are also not disturbing the dialogue track. So you need to experiment a bit, and then you can arrive at a decision. Okay, I think the folk part is going well. Let me find out a folk musician who could play for me. Or if the pop part is going well, let me figure out if there is a singer who wants to sing on to my film. So you will, one, get original music, which you don't have to worry about the copyrights. And secondly, you will get the feel right. So I feel that there needs to be a little experimentation with the soundtrack. So you the best way to do it is collect 5 tracks of pop music or folk music and try experimenting with your scene. So when you put one track, you will get a feel of, oh, this is going, this is not working. So try those 5 tracks and you will, I'm very sure among those 5 tracks, you will arrive at one which would fit in well with your scene. But as a side note, I would still suggest you or recommend you to use originally composed music. And there are a lot of musicians today who would want a portfolio or who would want to do a demo. So you could find them and you could use them on the movie. I hope this answers your question.
Yes, thank you very much.
Yeah.
Arvind sir, I wish to know from you, does the cameraman influence the director's decision on the appearance of given parts of the film that are recorded?
Okay, so personally, I believe influence is not the right word. Filmmaking is a team effort. So, as a director, I think that is the one who drives, and it's his vision. A cameraman may suggest how the visuals may look. Definitely, he's the one who gives. The director's vision, life. But the vision ultimately is the director. So to some extent, he may suggest. Influence is something which you can't actually change the director's views. But yeah, you can add to it. And if what you suggest adds to where the film is going, definitely I believe a good director will take that suggestion and go with it. So as a cinematographer, it is one job to see that he or she is adding to the script or the storytelling part of the film. So yes, we do suggest, we do tell, but finally it's the director's call to decide whether the suggestions are in the right direction and accept them. Does that answer your question, Martina?
Yes, thank you.
Ruto, sir, my question to you is, could you give us a few suggestions on how to write a good script?
Well, one of the main suggestions would be that good observation. Observation is most necessary for almost any of the things that you want to do in a film, and starts with the script. There's always a confusion between what is a script, what is a screenplay. That you must clarify for yourself and for the unit to be able to work properly. Satyajit Ray once said, a script is like a badly written novel. So from that you can make out that it's actually the story. It's the novel or a short story or a storybook. Now, when you're writing a novel or a story, you can write whatever you want. You can imagine anything and write. And because when someone is reading it, he or she imagines for themselves, and they can fill in all the put in all the meat over the bone. But when you're writing a screenplay, it has to be something in between a novel and a screenplay. I mean, sorry, when you're writing a script, It has to be something within between a story and the screenplay. The screenplay should have only what you see on the screen. Screenplay, what is playing on the screen. So you can't have, you can have him thinking, he can express that he's thinking, but you can't show what he's thinking about. In the novel, you can have what he's thinking about. You can write, he thought that, oh, when will she return? She has been away for such a long time. When I told her to leave, I didn't mean to say all that. You can write all that you want. In the script, you must put in the action, the description that he or she must do to express that. Am I being able to be clear?
Yes, sir.
Then you have to remember that these have to be broken down into shots. So you must be able to write your script in such a way that they are easily translatable to visuals. Okay, visuals. Remember, this is a visual medium. So visuals get a priority. And of course, supported by the sound. So something that you cannot maybe express through your visuals, maybe you can manipulate it in such a way so that you can use sound to tell what you are not being able to show visually. Then there is the genre you're trying to write, and you must be clear about that also, whether it's a comedy, whether it's a thriller, or is it a romance, because you are going to present your idea to a producer who's going to finance your film, and you'll have to explain, or even to the actors or anyone else, you'll have to explain what your film is about. So unless you are not clear about it, and unless you break it down, bring it down to whatever it encompasses, you will have to say, if I ask, okay, I'm going to finance your film, what's it about? So you say, it's a coming of age film, which is a romantic comedy, and it has adventure and sci-fi in it, and there's a thriller angle to it. So I'll say, wait. What is it about actually then? It has everything about it. So it's going to be a kitschery. It's a hodgepodge. So you must be clear about that. And also you must be very clear about how expensive it's going to be. We forget about that totally. We get so carried away with our imagination and our fervor that we forget about what we have to spend and how we'll be able to do that. So you must keep budget in mind very much. Because you can write that he lived in a castle and there were four towers and each had a golden top and there were chandeliers every 10 feet in the corridor. But you have to get all that to design your set. So, and someone has to pay for that. So you must be, there are many things that come into that. But the main thing you must start off with is that you must translate your written words into visuals. And write it like a story. Whereas in your screenplay, you will have it written as action to translate that script into visuals. And that will direct, give information to the cameraman, to the sound recordist, to everyone else. Okay?
Thank you, sir.
Thank you.
I would like to address the last question of today to Rohit, sir. Sir, my question to you is, can you please suggest tips on how to select a background music in a way that it does not overpower the dialogues in the film?
Now there are two parts to your question. The first one is selecting the score, and the second one is relating to something which we call mixing. So let me address the first part, how to select the background music. So right now, Subrata sir just said about the importance of scripting and having a good script. So music and sound start in the script, and then they come to the sound designer, and then they come to the set. So they start in the script. So as a scriptwriter or a director, you need to have small notes in the script as to, okay, I want emotional background score here, or I want this scene to be, you know, have a thrilling music or chase sequences there. What music does the director hear? Like when I say music, what what scores or what songs does a particular director here usually define what his background score is going to be. So if a director is listening to a lot of folk, jazz, or Western classical, he will be inclined towards having that kind of music in his films. If he's listening to a lot of rock music or a lot of electronic music, he will be, his musical decisions will be influenced by those genres. So you need to have references of music or background scores as to, okay, my background score needs to be like this. Okay, so what is the genre of that music and is it going with my subject? So that is how you select. So a lot of what you listen to, apart from your movie or apart from when you're just going for a walk or a jog or just, you know, doing something at home or doing nothing, and what you listen to usually dictates your taste in music. So that would be one thing. Secondly, your second part was regarding how do we ensure that the music doesn't interfere with the dialogue. So let me just explain to you a topography of the elements in a sound of a film or a soundtrack of a film. So if you look at a pyramid, the top of the pyramid is the dialogue, always. If it is a talkie film, it is the dialogue. The next will be foley or ambience, you know, just below the dialogue. And the next will be background music, because that's why it is called background music. It is at the background, it is not at the forefront. So the background music can never overpower or should never overpower your dialogues, because your dialogue is telling your story. Your actors, when they are speaking, they're telling the story, and that's how the audience is knowing the film. That's how the audience is understanding the film. So balance the dialogue, balance the background music in a way where it's just a feel. It is just giving you a feel. Unfortunately, the TV sector in India has pushed background scores way too much louder and changed the whole dynamics. I'm sorry, Subrata sir, but it's changed the dynamics of, yeah, the whole mixing of the music and dialogues. So always remember the pyramid. The top of the pyramid is the dialogue track. Next, your ambience, your effects, your foley, your footsteps, and then comes your background score. There are instances where, as a director or as a storyteller, you would want the background score to take over and mute the dialogues. This happens in suspense thrillers. When two people are talking and you want to create a suspense, you would mute the dialogue and you would push the music up. So the audience will keep thinking, oh, what they were talking. I'm giving you a very typical example. So you can use these tricks with background score to enhance the visual impact, enhance the storytelling. So again, I come to the original point that the story dictates a lot of things of what you do at, as how you go ahead. Yeah, I mean, I hope I've touched all the points.
Yes, sir. Thank you.
Subrata sir, what do you remember most about working on your first movie?
Oh, that's a long time back. But okay, but just before I get to that, can I just add a little bit to what Mr. Rohit said just now? When I was looking at all your films that you all made, I really wanted to say this also. Yes, there is the preponderance of music, too much music, because especially the ones from India, because I think that, again, as he said, that it has been the influence of television, which is quite, in my opinion, quite wrong at the moment, the way music is used. It must be much lower. Okay, but with what you asked just now, there are many, many experiences, but let me try to link it with something I said a little earlier. While writing the script, I said you have to remember about your budget. So I remember in one of the very early films I worked in, we had a very limited amount of budget, and we could use only 40 kilos of light. 40 kilowatts of light is, for now, the type of technology we have, the cameras we have, is a large amount of light. But at that time, it was minuscule. You could hardly light up a big hall properly with that. And the scene was supposed to be a forest, a night scene in the forest. I happened to be working as the assistant director, the art director in that film, both art director and assistant director. So I was like trying to think what to do, because in a jungle, if you're using that much, the limited light you have, we got to use, it would just light up about 15 square feet properly. So I racked my brains and I came up with a solution, which I remember, I was very happy with it. It worked out very well, so I remember it. What I did was, the film, it was in film. That's why 40 kilowatts of light was very little. In video, it's a lot of light, but for film, it's very little. So I went to the art department, I got a lot of white paint. It was in black and white, luckily. So what I did was, I asked the director to block his shot. So he said, it'll be from here. So I looked at the range, and what I did was I went to the furthest end where the light I knew wouldn't reach enough. And with the white paint, I shaded all the trees. I painted the trees on one side as if light was falling on the trees. So what happened in the dark, even if a little light fell on it, it separated it from the blackness. It looked like as if it was lit. And so the front of the forest was lit up. The shading, white shading, could be watched, seen at the back. And it looked like the whole screen was filled with light. Filled with light means properly lit. And that's how the shot worked out. So that was a nice experience I remember from one of my earliest films. I think you all should also innovate and be creative whenever you are making films like that, to overcome budget, to enjoy yourself working in film.
Thank you so much, sir. This Thank indeed you. Has been a wonderful session. On behalf of all the Slovenians, I would like to thank all our panelists for joining us here today on this platform. And now thank request you. Our Director of Education and Principal, Mrs. Revati Srinivasan, to say a few words and share her thoughts with us.
A very good evening to all of you. I must say that this has been a wonderful learning session for me too. A great fan of the cinema and the theater world. I think I have picked up nuances personally, and I'm sure that my students would, and I'm talking about the Polish students as well, would have really picked up a lot of tips from whatever you have been discussing over this period of time. I'd like to personally thank each one of you for being here. Nikhil Valal for talking about the story behind the Marathi theater and Marathi cinema that came across the evolution of Marathi cinema, one of the oldest ones. And of course, we have Subroto sir, who has been with us for a while now, for a couple of years that we have known him coming to school, talking to our students, giving them little nuances of every aspect of filmmaking. We have Arun Gupta, who has been coming to us, actually mentoring our students through and through with all their photography programs and projects. And the virtual photography exhibition that we held this year was, I would say, accorded a lot of success to Mr. Arun Gupta, who guided the children. So thank you very much. Rohit Pradhan has been a student of Singhania School. So I feel very proud that a Slovenian is coming forward to do it for the younger Slovenians. And Rohit has also been doing a lot of session with our students of MMC. And therefore, again, all three of you are part of the Slovenian fraternity, if I can put it. So thank you very much for being here. Nikhil Balal, I have no words to say thank you to you for your keynote address. He is also a part Slovenian because he's a parent of the school. So I would say that I've got all my parents and my students out here. A very big thank you to the teacher from our Polish partner school, Ms. Agatha, because I think Agatha has put across the films together, presented it today. And I would like to thank all the students over there for taking such keen interest. Filmmaking or any of these art, fine arts, to me is an aspect of creativity, which is a very essential part of one's personality. And if I see education as a whole, I do not draw a complete divide between curricular and co-curricular activities. They need to blend, because filmmaking, for example, is a wonderful tool to even teach. And I think using that films as a medium to express, medium to be able to use all our five senses, sense organs, in order to present an idea is a complete visual delight. And that also helps children understand better, especially when there are special learners. They get to understand better with films. So I'm so happy. I would like to congratulate all my students who participated in it. I cannot tell you how much of efforts they must have put in. You can imagine that, because they have spent all their Diwali break doing the films. And they did it so enthusiastically. And I think that comes from the fact that they loved doing what they were doing. Writing the scripts, putting them all together, everything together. I think all of that was completely done by the students. They were guided and mentored by all my teachers, headed by Mrs. Vaijayanti. And thank you, teachers, for all the support that you've been giving the students. This is a combined work of the IB students of grade 11 and 12 and the ISC students of grade 11 and 12. So I wish all my students the very best. Whether you are going to become a cinematographer or a filmmaker, I do not know. Whether you're going to be taking mass media for a career, I do not know. But all I know is that what you did yesterday and today would go a long way in shaping your personalities. It'll go a long way in having a feather in your cap, because you were able to make a film and you become a filmmaker at 16. And I think you can say that very proudly, because none of us did it when we were 16. So you are really, and I appreciate this of students when they write their first article or write their first blog. This is what I said. When I was 16, I didn't write my first blog. So I'm so proud of you that you wrote your first blog or you made your first film. There may have been errors, if you think they are errors, but areas where we can improve, and that has to be there. I would say that would happen even with a seasoned filmmaker. He would, after the film is released, he would still review it and critique it and say, oh no, I should have done it this way. Okay. And I think that's the world of improvement, the room of improvement that we all have. To all our lovely students, the Polish students and the Indian students, I'd like to say thank you very much for making this first Solonian International Film Fest possible. Thank you for being with us both these days, helping us put up this whole act together. And I'm so proud of you. That's all that I can say and end with. Thank you very much. I see a great future for all our students. Thank you.
Thank you, madam, for your kind words of encouragement. Creativity is about experimenting, growing, making mistakes, and learning from them. And what better platform to do this than that of experimental filmmaking? And as we draw the curtains on this Solonian International Film Festival, I would like to put on record my sincere thank you to a host of individuals on behalf of all the participants of this event. Filmmaking is a science, an art, and a craft. And this has been perfected by our chief guest, Mr. Anoop Jotwani, who graced us on day one and inspired us to surge ahead enthusiastically. I would also like to express my gratitude to our school management and our dear director and principal, Mrs. Revati Srinivasan. Thank you, madam, for being our guiding light. I would also like to sincerely thank all our panelists, Mr. Arun Gupta, Mr. Subrata Ghosh, and Mr. Rohit Pradhan, for speaking to us and deliberating on techniques.
A ship at high sea needs a radar to guide it. The students of the film club would like to thank our mentors, Miss Anushka Gupta, who taught us script writing, and Mr. Arun Gupta, who initiated us into cinematography. No road can be walked unless a guiding force watches you. I thus express my heartfelt gratitude to the teachers of the Solonian Film Club who have walked every step of the way with us, and the heads of ISC and IBDP for lending their support. A very sincere thank you to all my friends and classmates who have participated in this event, and those who have watched and appreciated our work over the last 2 days. A very sincere thank you to ex-Solonians, Rebecca Arambim and Nishan Singh Gupta, and Standard 12 Solonian, Rishita Gupte, for making short films on Phalke, Parallel Cinema, and Bollywood.
While a bunch of enthusiastic Solonians set about the task of experimenting with filmmaking on this side of the world, far away in another place, equally enthusiastic bunch of friends have put in their share of effort. I would like to thank our Polish partner school friends and their teacher, Ms. Agata, for participating in this event and adding a wonderful dimension to it. International programs have always aimed at shrinking the borders and adding an intercultural competence to it. Thank you all of you for helping us achieve this milestone. And finally, I would like to thank our dear parents for being the wind beneath our wings and helping us fly. Your constant support and encouragement means the world to us. And on that note, I, Sanika Devadi, draw down the curtains on this mega event. We do hope you enjoyed watching as much as we enjoyed making these movies for you. As we now come to an end of the Solonian International Film Festival, I request you all to rise and stand in attention for the Indian National Anthem.
Janaganamana Adhinayaka Jaya Hind Bharat Bhagya Vidhata Punjab Sindh Gujarat Maratha Dravida Utkala Vanga Vindhya Himachala Yamuna Ganga Uchchala Jaladhi Taranga तव शुभ नामे जागे तव शुभ आशीष मांगे गाहे तव जय गाथा जन गण मंगल दायक जय हे भारत भाग्य विधाता जय हे जय हे जय हे
Thank you all for watching. Have a wonderful evening ahead.